Welcome back, lawn lovers. BW here again. It's time for another fungicide application. It's November 11th today, and there's a significant snowstorm coming tomorrow. This may be my last chance to get my second round of fungicide applied for snow mold this year. Thing number one about snow mold. Most university research and manufacturers of fungicide recommend two fungicide applications, and that two or more fungicides be used in combination or sequentially for areas that experience long periods of snow cover. I used propiconazole in my first application in my last video on October 23rd. It's 3 weeks later now, and time to get my second application of fungicide down for snow mold prevention. The second application should be made a month after the first application, or just before lasting snowfall, whichever comes first. There's been some interesting new research from the University of Wisconsin indicating that the first fungicide application should be applied when the 2-inch soil temperature drops to about 43 degrees. Coincidentally, that does occur approximately 1 month before snowfall here most years, but this year has been a little warmer than most, making proper timing a little more ambiguous. I'm using Heritage G for this application. The active ingredient is azoxystrobin. It works best on gray snow mold. The propiconazole I used on the first application should take care of the pink and speckled snow mold. I could have mixed these two fungicides together, or just used Headway G for both applications. If tomorrow's snowfall melts, and I get a few more weeks of snowless weather, I'll mix the two for a final application. Thing number two. You might find gray, speckled, and pink snow mold all growing in your lawn at the same time. Gray snow mold has a grayish to white cottony mycelium, or fuzz, that you can see just after the snow melts. A day or two later, the only thing left will be brown matted down grass. You can identify gray snow mold by the large brown or copper color sclerotia it produces as seen here. The sclerotia is what survives and produces next year's fungus. Speckled snow mold looks similar to gray snow mold, but it has much smaller black sclerotia that look like black pepper flakes, but I don't currently have any close-up enough footage to show those. Pink snow mold produces mycelium or fuzz that's pink in color, like the name implies, but doesn't produce sclerotia. The mycelium and pink color fades quickly with exposure to daylight. The mycelium itself will produce more snow mold next year. You can sometimes tell gray from speckled by the darker center of the patch, but that identification tool is not as reliable as the sclerotia. Gray snow mold is common in the eastern United States, and speckled snow mold in the far northern tier of the United States, where snow cover lasts for more than 90 days. You can get pink snow mold anytime and anywhere wet weather gets below 60 degrees. Thing number three. Snow mold isn't choosy. It will damage all types of cool season grasses. Gray snow mold usually doesn't kill the grass, but the truth is that pink and speckled snow mold can. If you live in an area that only gets gray snow mold, you're not likely to think snow mold is a problem because gray snow mold doesn't kill the grass. But if you live in an area that gets speckled snow mold, it's a real problem. Fortunately, most people that live in the areas that get speckled snow mold have lawns containing large percentages of Kentucky bluegrass, which spreads quickly and fills in most of the grass lost from speckled snow mold. It can take quite a while, though, where there's heavy damage, and you will notice that the grass is thinner in those areas. Some of the newer varieties of Kentucky bluegrass are more snow mold and winter tolerant than other varieties, as you can see here. My front lawn is 70% perennial ryegrass and 30% Kentucky bluegrass. Ryegrass doesn't spread and repair damage, so I'll need to reseed perennial ryegrass if I lose any. That's why I'm so interested in the subject of snow mold prevention. Don't forget to like this video, and then hit the subscribe button and ring the bell next to it so that you don't miss the next video. We'll take one last look at my renovation before snow cover. And remember, you can do it.